newly House approved bill, which is the SOGIE Bill. Hashtag SOGIE Bill!
This Senate bill was recently approved by House of Representatives last September 2017. SOGIE Bill stands for Sex Orientation, Gender Identity, and Expression Equality Bill.
So in this talk, we will be evaluating the bill into three different aspects: the claim of policy, fact, and value.
Before anything else, the views and opinions in this vodcast are merely personal opinions of the cast and do not necessarily reflect the official policy and position of any agency in the Philippine government.
So our first topic will be about the bill's policy. So it is stated in this bill that whoever discriminates any members of the LGBTQ community will be sentenced to do fines or to be sentenced to imprisonment. So what do you think are the advantages of this policy?
So I think that one of the advantages of this policy is that the discrimination rate of this in the society will become lesser, because there is a policy and the discriminators will be forced to accept them, accept the LGBT members, and also they will eventually accept them. Eventually, yes.
And also they have this respect and differences, because people will be guided because of this bill that they, despite of differences, they should have the acceptance and the respect to these homosexualities or where all their LGBT communities. And also people are guided by this SOGIE bill that we are equal, we should have this equality, and people have the right to be treated right and just.
Because after all, people, they're still humans. They must be respected as humans, and their rights must be as well as the same with the people who are not homosexuals, right? So aside from those opinions, I think its advantage is also equality in workplaces, in schools. Because as like in the news, there was a student, a homosexual student expelled because he was homosexual, because he was studying in a Catholic school, and I don't think that is right, because homosexuality must not be any reason to be denied the advantage of knowledge, of hard work, of success. Don't you think?
Yes, I agree with that, because I think that it's injustice and unfair, because just because he is homosexual, and that is why he is expelled, and because we have the rights to be given education, to be accepted.
Yes, because maybe that school will help him to grow better, and maybe that kid will help the Philippines to
the problem
progress. And also sexuality is in the basis to in gaining knowledge.
But as of now, since the bill is not yet implemented, well, maybe the school also has their rights to implement their own regulations. But with the help of this bill, maybe we could slowly change that kind of thinking and give equal rights to the people and to the homosexual community.
Also, they're able to be aware. However, this SOGIE bill also have the disadvantages.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And the disadvantages of this bill is still we don't know that some of the LGBTQs or like the discriminators will use this as a cover up for the mistakes they've done.
Yes.
And this bill really ensures the safety and security of LGBTQs, and it has a great grounds in terms of sentences and the fines. That I believe that if the discriminators or LGBTQs use them or abuse this, then the person who does the mistakes will be safe from what he or she done.
It may be a case of discrimination. However, it is not yet fully ensured or structured in the bill of what kind of discrimination.
Yes, they're not able to specify discrimination.
Yes.
Yes. And also, maybe there are some lapses in implementing this bill because they didn't specify and various kinds of discriminations.
So we will be talking more about that later. So this time, in this talk about the claim of policy, the policy of this newly newly approved bill, we believe that it has a lot of advantages as well as equality and rights, the fight for rights and justice for the homosexual people. However, there may be people who may abuse this bill in order for their own benefits, to protect their mistakes, to cover up their mistakes. So everything must be in due process when implementing this bill. In context of values, morals, and ethics, this bill, or the SOGIE bill, really says yes in same-sex marriage. And this bill protects and accepts the same-sex marriage. So, can you give me some the advantages of same-sex marriage in the SOGIE bill?
First and foremost, maybe the advantages of this bill is that the acceptance of love, because these homosexuals are still humans. They're able to express their loves to one another, maybe to their different sexuality or their the same sexuality.
Yes, and also they have their freedom to express their emotions and the expression of love to whoever they may love, and also accept.
They're given the freedom to choose what they want and enjoy it without people saying no against it, because it's already approved.
And also connection is like sense of belongingness. Maybe they found the love, or they found comfort not into their opposite sex, but it is with the same sex with them, because I believe what's just said, that love is love. And maybe that belongingness really gives the light in their lives.
Despite this very gorgeous advantages, of course there are always disadvantages in same-sex marriage.
Yes, so one of the disadvantages of same-sex marriage is in a religious context. As we all know, in a religious context, God do not allow same gender to be in marriage, and also as the Catholic Church, they don't allow same-sex marriage, and also because they believe that it is unacceptable, yes, in a religious context, and also they don't, yes, do not allow. Yeah,
but also in our culture, because we believe that man is for the woman, because as a Filipino, we grow as a well-disciplined, especially in our house, and our parents teach us that you should be with a man, you should be with woman.
Mm-hmm. Yes, because we Filipinos are naturally conservative.
Yes, yes,
with our genders.
Of course, we're abiding really with the Holy Bible, because most of us Filipinos are Christians, right?
Yes.
Yes. Aside from that, another disadvantage is that people might discriminate children.
Yes.
Because
yes,
over time, over the centuries in our history, we are very conservative with our culture of being of the roles of a man and a woman. In this context, the people may have the tendency to discriminate the children of homosexual couples because of the absence of the proper mother and the proper father. Right? Don't you think?
Yes. But people will really take risks in the name of love.
Yes.
People is really eager to fight everything just for love.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and I believe that homosexuals will really do their best for their children, because I believe sexuality isn't a basis for being the good and the best parents.
To wrap this up, we have discussed the advantages and the disadvantages of same-sex marriage in the approval, in the possible approval of this SOGIE bill. So the advantage is the freedom of expression of love, and of course the right of people to express their choices, their needs. However, these are always contrasted by the culture of the Filipinos and the history of the society.
So for the third and the last topic, we'll be talking about the validity and the issues on the bill. So what do you think are the possible questions for the validity of this homosexuality, for the issues of facts?
Oh, so personally, I think that there may be questions of the validity of identifying yourself,
yes,
as a homosexual. Because in the Philippines, or I don't think in other countries, there's a process of, or a procedure of saying you're a homosexual. Because there's really no file saying a card for homosexual, or a valid homosexual, because it's first and foremost, or mostly, or for most people and for most scientists, is psychological and it's a personal choice.
And also, there is no guidelines or standards set by the government.
Yes.
That really validifies or telling you that you are homosexual.
Yes.
Or not.
Yes. And I think that this would be identifying the law, the laws or the sentences or the benefits of the homosexual. So it's really important that there is a guide, a basis for identifying homosexuals, so as to not be deceived by another problem.
Yes, because we can't really say that this person is homosexuals because it is too feminine, because homosexuals is really, really serious case.
Mm-hmm.
In
it's actually based on choice, so you have to know your identity first before you know you're a homosexual. So
yes, because maybe these people are just not aware of who they really are. They are just not, maybe in the personal background of them, they are very confused of their own sexual identity.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And as for homosexuality, there could be a reason why they are that
exactly.
Homosexuality are that way because of, say, because of the environment, the biologically, and also,
yes,
especially for choice.
Or maybe they're just trying to be in because homosexuals in this generation is really booming.
Yes.
And the LGBTQs rather has the empowerment right now in our society, and maybe they're just really trying to fit in.
Yes, and basically in this context, we can say that this kind of identity in this part of ourselves is changing. For example, a bisexual can definitely become a pure lesbian person, right? Like, it can be changing according to your choice because there's no standard. What else can be another issue on this topic or questions?
Just like what I said earlier, that there's no specific guidelines.
Yes.
that a person or an LGBTQ is following upon telling that he or she is homosexual or not. And that really is questionable for the people, because they can easily say that I am a homosexual, that I am a lesbian, and I am a bisexual. So standard or guideline really plays a big role in declaring yourself that you are a homosexual or not.
And also, in spite of these questions, we also have these issues in the homosexualities, this cross-dressing as deception.
Yes.
In addition, some schools are prohibited the students to avoid cross-dressing.
Yes.
Yes, because it is in the laws and it is in the regulations in schools.
So to wrap this up, so we have many different issues about validity about the bill, the homosexuality of a person. And with this, we have to accept what they are, and also we have to accept who we are and what we really are, and we don't need to deceive anyone for them to know us. And we have to be true to ourselves, and yes, that's it.
In conclusion, SOGIE Bill can be beneficial to homosexuals, but it may also have detrimental tendencies. Approved or not, Filipinos must respect others despite differences to maintain justice and peace in our society. Our values must uphold our humanity as we are all equally created by God.
Yes, that's true, and now that's a wrap on our talk about the SOGIE Bill approval in the Philippines.
Once again, this is Psyche Talks, reminding you to talk your thoughts.
Thank you for watching,
and God bless you.